This is our film captive for our final major project. We're not sure about the main title, the name. It's either between kidnapping or captive. Our target audience for our film is 15 or older to 35 at least, and the social economic status for the film will be working class and below, and the psychographic of our audience are explorers.
What's an explorer?
They seek discovery and I think there's something about like they seek discovery, they want something new. They have to try and find something for them,
okay.
Something to need.
So how did you come to the conclusion that it was working class or below? And what is working class?
Someone that's employed. No, because we did the focus groups. I did it from there. From my questionnaires, I've got all my results of what everyone put.
So you found out what socioeconomic status they were?
Yeah, most people put working class because they've got a job.
Okay. Middle class people have jobs, supposedly.
Yeah.
What impact does that have on your planning?
I haven't really had a lot in
that. Okay, we'll talk about it after you finish. But
our film is about a man that wakes up in a shack and he's like taped together, and also gagged or something, mm-hmm. like sellotape. And he wakes up and he finds himself in the shack room, and then there's like a bin bag, like from a previous killing that a kidnapper, but he doesn't know there's a kidnapper there. Then there's the bit about the sound timer, as you heard before. But I was thinking of ways to like try and like make it sound like he's left the sound timer there on a purpose for him when he gets back. So I was thinking like he could write a note or something, or write it in blood on the floor, so like the audience then knows that he has to quickly escape before he gets back. But and then so he finally sets himself free, and he escapes, and then he bumps into the kidnapper. That they become face to face, but the kidnapper, I don't think he should get shown due to tension. Like, maybe like a piece of his leg and the weapon that he has should get shown. And it ends up in a cliffhanger there to bring the audience's mind more alive and think about what's going to happen next. Kind of a thing. The location that we're thinking of is in a Welling, like near Gosling. It's like a shack. I think that they've used it in a previous short horror movie, but we're not quite sure where it is, so we're trying to get people to like kind of guide us in the right direction.
Mm-hmm. I know the building you're talking about.
Yeah. But
I don't know where it is exactly, but
it's up in near Gosling somewhere.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're thinking that should be like a reasonable place to do it.
Okay.
The props we will use is duct tape, fake blood, knife, a sound timer, and a Sasha weapon. We're not really, I don't know what Sasha weapon we have actually officially decided on, because obviously you've got a selection. And a mask to hide the identity of the kidnapper. The equipment we're using is Canon XX 100, boom pole, the windbreaker, the microphone, obviously, XLR lead, and the tripod. Tom Joy is director, James Gorman is assistant director, script supervisor. Ollie is the cameraman, and I'm the director of photography. The budget, because we're not using any college equipment, it doesn't really cost anything. So we like worked out the props, which should be like come up to like, at least £20 or something, or maybe lower.
Okay, what are the details of it?
Pardon?
What are the details of the props?
Of the props, what we're going to buy.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is what for the prop section. We don't know how much it is. I'm guessing we can make our own fake blood, but just get a mask.
Yeah.
And knife should at least come up to a 10.
Do you know how to make fake blood?
It's corn slash and food dye.
Yeah, basically, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you were here for the lecture, weren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The schedule times. Our production should start on the 16th of May, so we've like started filming then. Hopefully our group will like get everything, all the filming done, and then hopefully we'll have enough time to edit it as a rough edit as well, because I don't want us like all stressing out over 2 days for editing as well. So let us get all the film. Thank you for listening. Any questions?
What I'm interested in, you chose to use the term working class rather than Tom. Your other group members' presentation used, was it E to C2?
Yeah.
Why did you choose to use the term working class, not go with, you know, a socioeconomic scale? Because I feel that working class has got certain connotations rather than the letters E to C2, which kind of, I think, have been developed because it removes those negative connotations.
Yeah.
Is there a reason behind that?
No, there's no reason behind it. I think I just put it down because that's what I read on the paper thing.
Okay, so I think you need to think about that carefully for future projects.
Mm-hmm.
Just watch out for using terms like that, because I think if I say working class, I think the term has got historical associations with it.
Yeah.
Which some people might think are negative. And not only that, but you know, middle class people and upper class people work too.
Yeah.
So I don't think the terms are that relevant anymore, and there's a much bigger spectrum of people than just those three different classes. You know, it's who was here? Were you here during the interview, the presentation yesterday from Ian Lee?
Oh yeah.
He talked about BBC, Three Counties Radio. Have someone, what was it, Susan?
Yeah.
They actually create a fictional character for their audience, you know. So presumably you guys created audience profiles with Kelly, right?
Yeah.
So their audience profile is a woman called Susan, who's got two kids who are at university. That's their kind of, you know, that gives them some kind of an understanding of who their audience is. And it kind of, you know, gets them to understand who they are. So, I mean, how can you give me a bit more detail about the audience, I guess is what I'm saying.
The audience is obviously like around our age, like 15 or older, probably doing some type of education or working or having a job. I don't know, like they came, like with the psychographic thing, it came between like Explorer and I think it was like
How did you do your research? What methods did you use?
Questionnaire. We did the FMP group. No, that's the FMP group. But we had to like have an audience. And then
focus group.
That's the focus group. Yeah, and then we had to have like give out questionnaires beforehand, and I put down the size. Sociographic and they could mark what one they are. And then I did a pie chart of what one's the most and went from that.
Okay. Thank you, Johnny. Cheers.